Hi, I'm Lauren, and it's Friday of Lollapalooza, also known as the Lady Love Day, because so many kick-ass women here today. Shade was just performing The New Respects, one of my favorite new bands. Maggie Rogers, Sigrid, Bishop Briggs, Japanese Breakfast doing two sets, and your new favorite artist, who is taking the BMI stage at 5:40. This is Upsahl.
What's up?
Hi.
Thanks for having me.
Thanks for stopping by. I know you're a little bit busy.
No, I'm loving it. This is so much fun.
Well, this is your first time in Chicago.
It is, yeah.
And you were here yesterday. We actually ran into each other on Fox 32 News, where she did this unbelievable solo acoustic performance.
Thank you.
I still have chills just thinking about it.
Yay, thanks.
But you did get some Chicago time. So you did like some Chicago
activities.
I saw
the bean. That was my big thing I wanted to do was go see the bean. Mm-hmm. I got a photo. I did the touristy thing.
Photo's dope, by the way.
Thank you. I know. I really tried on that one. But yeah, no, it's been fun. I love Chicago. It's rad.
And you even got some Lollapalooza-ing in
already. I did. I got to see the Strokes yesterday, which was awesome, and King Princess. It's just fun. Just to like see people playing before me and like artists that I love, and to think we're playing the same festival is kind of crazy.
Yeah, it's amazing. It's your first Lollapalooza, and you're
so
playing
stoked.
It.
Yeah, it's dope. It's
well,
dope.
That's just a testament to how freaking talented you are.
Thank you.
So, it's, I mean, obviously a time of a lot of firsts for you in your career, and I want to talk to you about some of your firsts, like the first artist that really sticks out to you that really wanted to make you become a musician.
Yeah, when I was like. Well, so my dad was in punk bands when I was growing up. So I loved alternative music, and I was around the punk music scene. So I grew up listening to bands like Weezer and Spoon and The Shins and Beck and stuff like that. And then, but I remember a really big moment for me was my mom made me a mixtape of a No Doubt CD. And then I started to just like idolize Gwen Stefani because she's just this badass woman who's just doing exactly what she wants. Like she has this like group of guys backing her, and it's just really badass. And she kind of was a very like inspirational figure for me, like growing up as a girl who liked music. Yeah,
I love that your mom made you a mixtape.
Yeah, my mom.
That is parenting done right.
Right.
Wait. So I also read in third and fourth grade you were doing covers for like school talent shows.
Always. Yeah, I was obsessed. Any chance I could get in front of an audience and perform, I would do it. Like literally as much as I could, because it was the only thing I liked to do. So.
Well, it's obviously in your blood. Let's talk about the first instrument that you ever picked up.
I started piano when I was 5. My grandma started teaching me classical piano, and then I started guitar shortly after. So those have kind of become like my main instruments. Yeah.
Well, I saw you on the guitar, and you are fantastic. What's the first album that you ever purchased with your own money?
That's a good one. I actually think it was the first Tame Impala record on vinyl, actually. There's this record store in Phoenix, my hometown, called Stinkweeds, and they were always like selling my CDs there. They're super sweet. And I think that was the first thing I got from there, actually.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. So we're obviously going to be in the pit for Tame Impala tonight.
Of course. They're like my favorite band. Yeah.
Obviously. What is the first song that you ever wrote?
I started writing really horrible songs when I was like 5, obviously, because I was like, oh, I'm going to be a songwriter. And then I released my first song. It was called Disturbance. It was the most like emo, really sad song. And my parents were like, is she okay? She's like 12 writing these really depressing songs. And yeah, it's somewhere out on the internet. I'm sure
people
can find it. But it's pretty funny. I was like 13. Yeah.
Do you remember like one line from it or a bar?
It was like, oh, what was it? At the end, it was like, but now we're going to have to live with the disturbance. Like, that's so depressing from a 12-year-old. My parents were so concerned. Yeah, it's pretty funny.
You're deep. You're wise beyond your years.
I guess. That's what they say, I guess.
What was the first concert you ever attended?
I think it was Weezer. I was like 3, and I think it was a festival, because there's like videos of me like dancing around in a little sundress while Weezer is playing. I'm pretty sure that was the first concert.
Your first concert is supposed to be nerdy. You know,
no, mine was cool.
You were born into cool royalty.
I love it.
Do you remember your first kiss?
I was 15, and it was in the backyard of this like birthday party for somebody. It was really awkward and horrible. Yeah, it was fun.
That's how it
Good
should
stuff.
Be.
Yeah.
All right. Well, you released your first album when you were 14.
Yes.
And we've got the Hindsight 2020 EP, which is absolutely amazing. And then Wish You'd Make Me Cry was a separate release.
Yes.
So is this all leading to a debut LP?
Maybe. I don't know. I'm at a point in my life where anytime I'm not traveling and I'm just like in LA, I'm literally in sessions every single day, writing a new song every day. So I have so many songs that I want people to hear. And yeah, I'm really loving the music I'm making right now. So the goal is to just put out as much music as possible. I don't have a plan if it's going to be an album or a bunch of singles or another EP, but I just want people to hear more music because like I'm changing as a person. My music is changing. Like I'm just really excited about everything that's to come. Yeah.
I heard are there really hundreds of songs that have been written?
It's wild. I never thought that was possible. And then, yeah, I moved to LA and writing every day. Like I think I'm up at like 350 songs since I moved there. It's crazy. It's so weird. But yeah, and so like obviously there's ones in there where I'm like, I need people to hear this. Mm-hmm. So I'm working on it. Trying
to get
more
music.
One day
you're just going to drop 350 songs on us and we're
going to 350 song album. I'm like, there you go. Yeah.
Well, I'm really excited.
Thank you.
Upsahl, obviously taking the BMI stage at 540 here, and you can check her out across all platforms. Seriously, the future of music.
Thank you.
You're witnessing it right here.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Well, thanks for stopping by. Upsahl.